One would say she's addicted. Good morning, you guys. Welcome back to Vlogmas day 15. That means we are 3/5 of the way through. I'm kind of sad about that. I've really been loving Vlogmas this year. It's been really fun. I was just setting up so I could film day 3 of 25 days of manifestation for TikTok. Today is 12/12, December 12th, so it's the 12/12 portal, which happens every year, but specifically this year, because it's 2021, the date is just so interesting. 12/12/21. All of which are multiples of 3, and then 1 plus 2, so like in the 12 and in the 21, are both 3 as well. And so I was thinking through a manifestation exercise that would work really beautifully with that, and I came up with a really good one. And as I was like thinking it through, I looked up and checked the clock, and it was 12:21 p.m., which was so wild. I was like, what is happening? Decided to film this. Accountability check, baby. It is the most beautiful sunny Sunday in the... Okay, don't knock this over. Beautiful sunny Sunday in New York City. Blue skies, baby. Why is the camera not focusing? There we go. How gorgeous is that? Welcome to day 3 of 25 days of manifestation. When everything is white, glimmering. Okay, I'm wearing the cutest parka. I got this from Rent the Runway. It says perfect moment all over it. Let me see if this is anything else. Mostly just perfect moment. I dressed in an athletic outfit since I'm gonna do a little Central Park walkie walk, or at least just be active. Don't look at my bed, I need to make it. Oh man, I just feel so much happier in the days that it's sunny. Perfect weather. Family's near. We give thanks for this past year. Okay, I am home and it's just about time for the oracle reading. I went a little hard at MAC. I got a few fun things. I'm gonna put on my new concealer because I just ran out. I got the NC25. I am feeling exhausted. Sometimes if I am like out in a public place, like, I mean, Nordstrom's not a mall, but kind of like a mall or a big shopping center for several hours, I almost feel like I can take on other people's energy and just start to feel kind of like overwhelmed and chaotic and like a little bit annoyed, which isn't really my personality type. Before I head into this oracle reading, I am definitely going to meditate, ground my energy. I just imagine that there's a grounding cord connecting my first chakra at the base of my spine all the way down to the center of the earth, and that it works like a vacuum cleaner and just pulls anything and everything out of my space that's not mine or not serving me or that I'm ready to let go of. And it really does help. I also got like 10 types of new lipstick. Let's try this lip pencil. Probably the most fun part. Got me home and trying this stuff. This lip pencil in color Dervish. Dervish. That's it. Okay. Fun. Let's do our oracle reading. Exactly what I thought it was gonna be about. The messages were so clear. I would share more, but you guys have to join in on the oracle readings. I've decided that I am going to stay in tonight. I was going to ride on the Peloton, but still am having that issue where my cleat isn't working. So instead, I'm gonna do some yoga. Do my 10 minutes of movement as yoga. I think yoga will help me just get back into my body, into my breath. It's been a hot second, just like a quick 20 minute flow. Very meditative to me. It was wonderful, so good to get my body moving. My heart definitely feels like, I mean, I've not done yoga in a while, so that was very intense and hard. I'm excited to grow my practice again. I used to do yoga all the time when I was a sophomore in college. I would go every day, sometimes twice a day, and I was at one of my strongest physically and mentally at that time, so it was really fun to revisit that. I had an idea for a Vlogmas video to answer life's big questions about the universe, manifesting, spirituality, and so I asked you guys to submit some questions or topics on my Instagram story a few days ago, and I want to attempt to answer some of them. Disclaimer, these answers, there's no way to verify them. I don't want to invalidate myself right off the bat, but what I'll say is I'm going to answer these questions to the best of my ability based off the things that I have studied, based off of my personal experiences, what I've come to learn about the world and my worldview. We all have very subjective worldviews, so it's very rare that two people have the same worldview. However, my intention with this topic for a Vlogmas video and to close out day 15 is to bring you some comfort and some perspective based off the things that I believe. There's a lot of questions here. I'm just gonna take them as they stand out to me. The first question is, what do you think the key to self-healing is, or letting yourself let go of the hurt? I talk about EFT, emotional freedom technique, at great length because that is the only thing that I found that has truly the power to help you release any emotion that you are ready to let go of. This could be pain that you were dealing with from a recent event that's happened. This could be trauma that keeps coming up again and again, a painful memory. EFT is just the most powerful thing I've found. So I have numerous podcast episodes that I'm gonna link below that explain EFT. I have one with my EFT practitioner, Tiffany Jeffers. I have one with Brad Yates. You can check out his free EFT resources on his YouTube channel. And I have a tendency to mention EFT, and even I have a tendency to mention EFT in every single one of my own podcast episodes because it's what I do with clients, it's what I do in myself. I see my practitioner every 3 weeks, sometimes every 2 weeks, for really powerful sessions. Brad Yates describes EFT as emotional acupuncture. So you use these points, front of the eyebrow, side of the eye, underneath the eye, and collarbone. I'm gonna link a video up here, EFT Do It Yourself, that explains more. And it releases the emotional resonance or that emotional gut reaction that happens when you think about something that was painful, when you think about a trigger point. It has just helped me so immensely. It really makes me feel empowered. Like I can handle anything that comes up because I have this tool, and therefore I can learn from everything that happens in my life without needing to hold on to the pain, because I used to really, really, really hold on to pain. And as I've let it go, and even release pain of past memories, things that I didn't even think were bothering me anymore, but if I really thought about something that happened in middle school, I could conjure some tears, some pain. For me, I feel everything. Some other people see it, or you hear a memory. And in this case, release it. It doesn't have to have a hold on you anymore, which I think is so powerful. Someone else asked, does the universe always guide you to a better place? My answer is a resounding yes. I think the universe has a vested interest in getting you to exactly where you need to be and your highest timeline in this lifetime, because this part trips me out a little bit. I don't think I've had enough life experience and time to completely zoom out to understand this, but what Abraham Hicks says is that we came into our bodies in this lifetime. We came to Earth school. We took up soul contracts in order to expand consciousness. And we expand consciousness by recognizing what we do want and what we don't want. And instead of ruminating on what we don't want, being like, okay, great, I don't want that. Let me focus instead on the things that are positive, and using that contrast to create new life and higher levels of consciousness. According to this, that means the universe does want to always guide you to a better place. It helps the world when you feel your best, when you're in the best place possible for your soul's mission on this earth.
I think we all came in with a very clear soul mission. Some of us are very acutely aware of it. Others of us are kind of still sifting through layers of invalidation and hurt. Believe me, that was me for a long time. But once you understand, wow, my biggest gift, I believe, is art, or I really love helping people this way, or my longest dream has been to be an Oscar-winning actor. You understand that when everybody is living at their fullest capacity on their highest timelines, it helps the world. Think about all the people who have helped you. It doesn't just have to be people in your life. Think about people you've never met, celebrities, musicians where you've loved their music, you've cried yourself to sleep to their songs, or like had the best days of your life singing their songs to the top of your lungs on the highway. Like, we all impact other people so acutely, and it's not only through the things that we create and what we are in the world, it's vibrational. Sometimes we all collectively feel really tired and burnt out. I think that's something that we're all feeling this week in particular, and it came through in the reading tonight as well. You deciding, I'm gonna meditate for a while on everything that makes me feel really happy and good, actually sends shockwaves out. And it's first going to impact the people immediately in your circle, the people you spend the most time around, family members, just those who are close to you, whether in proximity or because that you talk to them a lot, so you share energy with them a lot. And everything has a domino effect. I love that quote that says, you are not a drop in the ocean, you are the ocean in a single drop. You are the ocean in the single drop, but we are also all drops in the ocean. We are all oceans in the single drop in the ocean. We are all an expression of the same one beautiful power that is source, God, love, and the universe. And I don't think it's until we truly understand just how much we are one that we start to take that personal responsibility of, wow, the things that I'm seeing in my experience must be in some way related to what I'm thinking of myself, what I'm going through on an internal level. As within, so without, yet another podcast episode that I did. So that's a very long-winded way of answering and saying, yes, the universe always is guiding you to a better place because you are the universe experiencing itself through itself. And it's in everybody's best interest for you to get to the best possible place for you. Even if it's a stranger off the street, it is in your best interest that every single person out there lives the best life that they can and achieves the peak states of happiness because it impacts the entire world. We had a lot of questions about limiting beliefs. And I'll say a limiting belief basically is a belief that is a lie. In other words, you have come to believe something about yourself, about your place in the world or the world that is wrong, and it limits you as a result. So a lot of people have a limiting belief around worthiness. I feel like I'm not good enough. That's a huge one. So many people have that. Lack mindset, scarcity mindset, limiting belief. There's not enough abundance to go around for everyone, money is evil. There's all these examples of limiting beliefs. You recognize what your limiting beliefs are by the areas in your life that feel like you are being pinched off from greater levels of love, abundance, happiness, and success. You can also recognize it by looking at the people who might make you uncomfortable or make you feel envious. What do you believe they have that you don't? Or why does it irritate you that they are living a certain life and it feels impossible for you to live the same life? Work with your triggers to understand where these beliefs came from. And here's a trick for you. Anything that's not 110% pure love, pure self-love, pure abundance is free-flowing, is a limiting belief. Now, we can't just find all the limiting beliefs and get rid of them in one fell swoop. I've tried. But with every limiting belief, you start to rewire, and you rewire it by removing the emotional resonance through EFT and then changing your mindset through things like affirmations at night, linking a video about that above, the ThinkUp app that I always use, or just changing up your mindset through visualization, through how you talk to yourself, like strong mental toughness. Little by little, you'll start to rewrite what you believe about yourself and what is possible for you, which leads to so much immense healing. We're all on that journey to rewrite the beliefs we've just adopted from those who've come before us. We haven't second-guessed them. Our parents believed certain things because their parents believed it, because they grew up in a society that believed something, and we just keep perpetuating these same beliefs and these cycles until we decide to stop it. And that's why I have to say a huge kudos to you, because if you're still right here listening to this video, it's because you have the self-awareness to change it. Most people don't. And that's really epic, because as we do that work, we show other people that it's possible. It's not an us versus them, like, I'm doing the work and you're not. It's I'm doing the work to show you it's possible so that you may feel encouraged to do the work too. And again, best interest for all of us to succeed and achieve our highest timelines. Someone else asked, do you think all of us have a path laid out for us in this planet? I will answer that by saying, I think there are infinite paths for each of us, but we all have a very authentic energy to express. So while I have infinite paths in front of me and you have infinite paths in front of me, even though they're both infinite, they're different because you and I have very distinct and separate and different energies. This goes back to what I was talking about in my video on astrology. The time that you were born and the placement of the planets in the sky at that time, your birth chart shows your specific energy for this lifetime. And so according to that energy and the things that I think your soul wanted to come forth and do, there are all of these options. You could resist your soul's call. You could take a left every single time the universe was trying to make you take a right. You could follow every single urge and live the biggest life possible and do all the healing work and rewrite all of your limiting beliefs and really achieve that highest possible timeline, or you could ignore all of it. And I think as you survey in your life, you know people who have taken a lower timeline path. In other words, you know that they are made for more. You know that they are so talented at something and it drives you crazy, but they never put their effort towards that thing that they want to do. Or they've said forever they have this dream and they're never taking action towards it. But then there are other people in your life that you see who are freaking doing it all the time and they're always wowing you. These don't just have to be like people you're friends with. These can be people that you see on social media, people who are always setting that example. And it's not that some people are more gifted than others. I believe we're all equally gifted, or that some people are just destined to be more successful. It's who is choosing their highest timeline. We all have a highest possible timeline for ourselves. I think in this work, when we are rewriting our limiting beliefs and working towards something, we're working towards our highest timeline, which means the version of you who is unlimited, who is living in full alignment with everything that you would want to do and be. And to give you a hint, when you imagine your highest timeline, if you're feeling fuzzy on what that means, imagine you living your absolute dream life and then make it 100 times better. Up the abundance, up the love, up the happiness, up how you inspire and educate and entertain others. And that will give you a peek at your highest timeline. We are all destined for the highest timelines possible, and there's plenty of room. In fact, there's infinite room for us all to reach our highest timelines. We're all supposed to. But you always have a choice. When you choose to give into a limiting belief instead of rewriting it, part of it is normal. You've got to give yourself grace, but part of it that means that you're choosing a lower timeline. An example along these lines too is, I have wanted to be a singer since I was very young. And I completely gave up on that because of the things that I've mentioned. I'll link the video here. Wow, linking a lot of videos in this video around what happened in high school. Then I did some tapping with my EFT practitioner on wanting to be more of an entertainer and maybe have more opportunities to sing. Very quickly, because we create our realities, I had a friend reach out to me and say, hey, I have a friend who's playing piano at this bar. He's looking for singers. Are you interested? I was terrified, but I knew it was in accordance with a higher timeline for me, moving up towards my highest timeline to say yes to that. Then later on, I was supposed to practice with him and it was very inconvenient. I had to cancel something else for it. And then I realized, like, even the night of the performance, interrupted travel plans that I was thinking about, and I was just feeling really blah about going in general. I was feeling really nervous, and so I considered canceling for a good 10 minutes. I was like, maybe I should just not do this. Whatever, I tried, I thought about it. There'll be other opportunities. But I knew, I felt in my soul, no, the highest timeline is if you show up for this. Showing up for the highest timeline, in a lot of ways, it is supposed to be easy because it's you following your soul's call, but that also means you're going to do things that scare you a little bit. But ultimately, it's gonna be so fulfilling. I'm so proud of myself for getting up onto that stage because I know that was in direct alignment to my highest timeline. Am I on my highest timeline yet? I don't really think so, but we're working towards it all the time. And I believe there's been a lot of times that I've been on my highest timeline, and same for you. Long-winded way of answering and saying, we all have a path laid out, but it's up to you at any given time if you wanna change paths. Great question. Do we only need to act on inspired action, or must we act to try to make it happen? When you want something, when you're manifesting something, effort is really important, right? Like the word attraction and law of attraction has the word action in it. You have to take action. You can't just sit on your couch and be like, oh yeah, I want a book deal and not put anything out there. You need to take action. But when you are doing that action from a place of desperation and you're doing it in this frenzy and everything you're doing is as a means to an end rather than letting it flow through you, I think it soils the energy and therefore makes it really impossible for you to manifest. So say that it's a book deal. If everything you do, showing up on social media so you can build the following so that you can get a book deal, or networking within the publishing space, is for this end goal of getting this book deal, you show up with this energy of like needing things from other people. We can always feel it. It's very subtle. It's always subconscious, but there's a reason we're attracted to certain people on social media and we can't take our eyes off of them. And it's because they're doing what they're doing for the sake of what they're doing. They love posting. They love making videos for the sake of making videos, or they love writing for the sake of that. Or when you're having a conversation with someone, there might be sometimes you're like, kind of like put off by them, because you can kind of feel that they want something from you. You're like, are you in this to be like actually present and connect with me? Or is there like a deeper level here? Is there an introduction you want? Is there, I don't know. People can feel it if the energy is a little bit impure. So when you're trying to make something happen, obviously you have good intention. We've all been there. You really want something. You're putting your best foot forward, but there is an easier way to do it. And that's stepping back a little bit and doing everything that's lining up for that manifestation. So if it's a book deal, spending more time writing. You wanna be an author, right? Lose yourself in the flow of writing, enjoy it. Show up to writer's workshops, connect with other writers for the joy of it. And then inspired action comes in, usually when you are falling asleep at night, taking a shower, riding your bike, driving a car, doing something where your subconscious is more at play, you're more relaxed, and all of a sudden you might just get a jolt of, oh my gosh, I need to go into that supermarket. Oh, I should really call my professor from college. I haven't talked to them in forever. And you never know why, but you act on those little impulses, and then it's almost like the universe is giving you little breadcrumbs to guide you to where you need to go. So the best possible combination is to love every single step that you take towards your manifestation and do it as an end within itself rather than as a means to the end of the manifestation, and then trust when inspired action comes, as opposed to trying this hustle, trying this efforting, trying this, I gotta go get this and I'm gonna do it at any cost type of movement. Powerful question. Do you think everything happens for a reason? Yes. I strongly, strongly, strongly believe that. I believe so powerfully in fate and in finding meaning and reason to everything that happens. And there's so many arguments against it, and I understand the arguments, but what I will say is that at the end of the day, it brings me the most peace to believe that everything happens for a reason and that everything has a deeper meaning or there's something predestined in all of it. Otherwise, it's really easy to be devoid of faith and to feel like everything's random. I also think that can lead to a lot of anxiety to think that everything's in your own control. I think you meet the universe halfway. I think the universe wants to know what you want for your life. It wants to see how you're showing up. It wants to see how you're releasing burdens and past traumas and limiting beliefs so that you move towards your higher timeline. But I also think everything's happening for a reason in the sense of the universe is always guiding you to that higher timeline. And so everything is working out beautifully and perfectly. I love this quote and this notion that everything's always happening for your highest good. And I think that's the same thing. Everything happening for a reason means it happens for your highest good. It's happening for you, not to you. I so strongly believe that there is fate involved. I just think there are things that you are destined for and things that you're not destined for. A little fun example that's coming to mind is, say that your parents are doctors. And so you feel like you need to be a doctor, but deep down you really, really, really want to be a painter. You are destined in this case to be a painter. You know that's what you want to do. You feel completely called to it. You have dreams of it. You have premonitions of it. Every psychic you've ever been to or astrologer you've ever been to has said you need to pursue art. You're like freaking Pisces. You got a lot of Pisces placements. Like, I always feel like Pisces love to paint. If you're starting to go after being a doctor, I think because you're not destined to do that, you're going to meet a lot of resistance on the way. Now, you could do it if you wanted to. You have free will. But it would also feel like you're going upstream. And I think if you got really honest with yourself, you'd be like, man, I don't wanna do this at all. I'm doing this to please my parents, or I'm doing this because of a limiting belief that I'm only successful if I go into a career in the sciences as opposed to the arts. You see how that happens? That doesn't mean that your free will is null and it doesn't count for anything. You do have a free will, but I think the path of least resistance is always the path that is destined for you. And so you have to trust when chaos starts to come up, when all these obstacles start to come up, it's probably because the universe is trying to get you back onto a different track. Now, I'm not saying that your track and your path in life is going to be perfect in a walk in the park. There are gonna be challenges, but here's the key difference. I believe the challenges that come up on the way to your biggest life dream usually force you to look at your deeper wounds. You encounter your biggest wounds on the way to your biggest dreams. If you are encountering obstacles that just feel really chaotic, like you lose service on the way to your job interview and so the maps isn't working. And then at the job interview, you realize you completely forgot your resume because your dog ate it. Like, all these little things start to happen that don't ask you to look deeper. That is a really different type of obstacle. Those feel like silly human obstacles versus the obstacles that you would face that aren't even obstacles. It's just prodding you to deeper levels of self-knowing and healing so that you can reach your biggest dream fastest. I will leave that here because I just talked for so long, but I'd love to know any other questions you do. I could do so many videos on this. It also gave me a lot of good ideas for my podcast. I am going to make some chicken nuggets, and I'm also gonna start Succession tonight on HBO because everybody keeps talking about it. But thank you for submitting these questions. I could talk for hours, as you could tell. And there were so many other questions. We'll have to do part 2, 3, and 17.